students. So, myself Sunil Sharma with my colleague Rajesh Tamanna again welcomes you all in Department of Biology, School of Public School, Barbajan. So, today we are going to perform another experiment, and that is about the effect of the temperature on active saliva amylase. Now, you all know saliva amylase is an enzyme which is found our saliva, which helps in the digestion of starch. Now, being the enzyme, saliva amylase ensures the effect of the previous temperature. Saliva amylase and the previous temperature, definitely there will be some effect on the action of the
dissolve it in 100 ml of water. Okay, fine. Then next, what is it?
Starch powder.
Starch powder.
And 1 gram of starch powder in 100 ml of water.
Okay, fine. Okay, that means you want to say you take the starch. How much amount of the starch you have?
1 gram.
Okay, 1 gram of the starch you took over there. Then you added in it. How much amount of the water? 100 ml of water, then boiled it
and leave it overnight.
After boiling, you cool down it and kept it overnight to mature.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so the starch get matures over there, and then next day you will use it. So you already did all this thing for the starch, for the maturation of the starch. Okay, fine. What is it? This is
sodium chloride.
Sodium chloride. Fine. For what purpose you are taking it?
Sir, we are preparing 1% of sodium chloride solution.
1% sodium chloride solution. How you will make it 1% sodium chloride solution, sir?
Take 1 gram of sodium chloride and add 100 ml of water in it.
100 ml of water in it. Okay, fine. So, the 1% solution you provided. Okay. And what is this? What is this dye?
This is the dye for the
For the experimentation part, okay. So on this tile, if I see, you have the some certain columns. One column is for the time. Okay. Normal water. Fine. Okay. 6 test tubes. Okay.
First, 3 test tubes
are the experimental tubes. Okay.
Controls.
Okay. What is the difference between the experimental tube and control tube? What you add in the experimental tubes and the control tube?
Solution.
Okay.
And
okay.
Starch solution.
Okay. at a diastase. And in controlled, you skip the diastase.
Instead of diastase, we add
1 ml of distilled water to maintain the equal volume. Okay, fine. Now, what you will do? You are boiling the water, I can see here.
Yes,
and
this is the cold water.
And here you have the cold water, okay.
And this is the normal.
This is the normal water, fine.
So take one experimental tube and one cold water.
Okay, one experimental and one controlled in the hot water.
Right. In the CD marker, it is experimental tube and this is the controlled tube.
Fine. Okay. For how much duration you put it in this?
When the achromic point will not get fined.
Okay, fine. Okay, next.
Second, take one test tube and one control and one experimental in normal water.
Okay, so one control test tube and one normal test tube, you put it into the normal water which is having the normal temperature.
And one control and one experimental tube.
Cold water. Okay, ice cold water it is. Fine. Okay, so you have the three setups. If I show in one frame to all these, then you have the three setups here. The one is, this one is of ice cold water. Then this one is the next is the normal water. And the third one you can see here is boiling water. Okay, fine.
Yeah. structure of the enzyme will get disturbed, and in that case, they will lose their action. That means in the hot water, enzyme will not work, and the effect of the enzyme will not be shown on the starch. Starch will not like this. Why? But in normal condition, the enzyme is functional.
Experimental condition, you will see the yellow color of the iodine will be observed, achromatic point will come over there, but that will be little later, it will be delayed because the enzymatic action is slow down here. So I hope that this experiment is clear to you. Remember one thing, always enzymes are temperature sensitive, and we can see the effect of the temperature on the action of the salivary amylase. So that's all from the side of Department of Biology, Subodh Public School, Jaipur.